Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Dana Marie. If you're new here, hey girl, what's up? Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. So in today's video, I'm here to do a review on Rare Beauty. It's by Selena Gomez. She just launched this on September 3rd. So yeah, she launched foundations, concealers, highlighter, eyebrow pencil, eyeliner, lipsticks, and a whole bunch more, you guys. So this is gonna be my first time trying everything. So if you wanna see the products that I got and how they work on me, then just keep on watching. I went to Sephora and I got some of these items, you guys. Rare Beauty's only sold in Sephora as of now. Hopefully they move to Ulta because I like Ulta better than Sephora personally. So yeah. First item I grabbed out of the bag is this makeup mist. I love the whole simplistic vibe of the packaging. This is what I've been into lately. Like, I don't like a lot of colors. I like very neutral colors. On the packaging, it says a glow boosting mist that hydrates, primes, sets, and refreshes the skin. I'm excited to try this, you guys, because lately I've been into like skincare and like what's good on my skin. This was $24, and I believe she said that you can use this before and after your makeup. The next item I grabbed out the bag is her makeup sponge. This was $14, and I've heard a lot about this item, you guys. I cannot wait to try this. Like, this is the most anticipated product that I have. The next item I grabbed is this lipstick. Well, it's called Lip Balm, and I got it in the shade Thankful. It's like this brown packaging. I think like her lipsticks or anything that goes on the lips is like a different packaging. Like, you know, the standard package is like white. I think the stuff that goes on your lips are like different colors. This lip balm was $16, and on the packaging it says a hydrating fuss-free balm that adds a hint of Just Kissed color and soft shine. So we're gonna see if that adds a little bit of oomph to my lips. The next item is the foundation. I got this in the shade 490C. This foundation was $29, and on the packaging it says a foundation elixir that feels barely there while building coverage and boosting your natural glow. I actually got this matched on my face in Sephora. I think this is like the perfect shade. Lately I've been into more of a dewy finish, so we're gonna see how that looks on my skin. The next item is a matte liquid liner. This is in the shade black. I heard this is like really, really good, you guys, so I'm excited to try this as well. I paid $19 for this. On the box it says it's an intense waterproof liner that delivers bold, even strokes with a calligraphy style brush. So I'm excited to see how that's gonna look, if it's really gonna be matte and like how intense the color is. So the next item I got is the illuminating primer. This is $26, and it says it's a weightless universal gel primer enriched with ultra fine pearls for a lit from within glow. I also picked up her liquid blush. So my understanding is that some of her blushes are more of a glowy finish and some of them are of a matte finish. So I got the one with the matte finish. I got this in the shade Love. On the box it says it's a long-lasting liquid blush that blends and builds beauty for a soft, healthy flush. I have been into blush lately, so I'm excited to see how this looks with everything put together. And this blush, you guys, was $20. The next item I got is the concealer. I got this in the shade number 470C. It says it's a moisturizing buildable concealer that melts seamlessly into skin for detectable cake-free coverage. This was $19. The last thing I picked up is the lip matte lip cream. This is in the shade Thrilling. It says it's a whipped lip cream that delivers comfortable one stroke color with a vivid velvety finish, and this lip cream was $20. Okay, so that's everything that I got, you guys. Now we're gonna get into actually trying out these products. I'm super excited. Let's just jump right into the makeup. She also launched a eyebrow pencil, and I forgot to get that, you guys. So yeah, I really wanted to try that because I heard it's really pigmented, but we're just gonna skip that part. That's why my brows are already done. So first things first, we're gonna apply primer. It's really pretty. Kind of reminds me of the Fenty Beauty one, like just the whole like mystic look of the bottle. It's definitely illuminating. Thank you. The primer actually feels really good on the skin, you guys. I like this, and it didn't leave my skin feeling super sticky. Now let's move on to foundation. I really like the whole aesthetic of this makeup line. I love the blush pink color, and I love how she put the ball on top here. It's like perfect for holding when you're applying the foundation. So I thought that was really cute. Now let's apply. I don't know if I got the right shade. She said this is my shade. What do you guys think? I think it's a little bit, I don't know. What do you guys think? I think it's a little bit too orange for me, actually. I feel like a Oompa Loompa. Like, I could work with it, but I don't know. Oh my god, I'm orange. This is not gonna work. This is not gonna work, bruh. I look like a Oompa Loompa. Like, this is not cool. I can't go nowhere with this. We're gonna move on to concealer. I got the shade 470C. This is what it looks like outside of its packaging. It's just a smaller version of the foundation. I think it's really, really cute. Oh wow, a lot of product came up on that doe foot applicator. Oh, everything is too orange. No, I don't, this is way too much. I don't know what that girl was thinking. The undertone of this concealer is like perfect. She did a really good job with getting the undertones. It's like really nice and warm. We're gonna blend this out with her sponge. I've heard so much about this. I'm excited to try it. But the sponge comes in this little bag. And should I damp it? I don't know. Yeah, I'm gonna damp it real quick. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. All right, let's blend this out. It's really soft. The sponge looks like the Sephora cleansing sponge, just because it has like huge pores. I think the shade is way too close to the foundation shade. I don't think it's giving me that highlight that I'm looking for. This is not giving me highlight. This is just giving me concealed. So yeah, I would definitely choose a different shade. But in terms of the consistency, really good. I'm gonna go ahead and set this concealer and contour my face and also do a little bit of bronzing because she doesn't have those products. So I will be right back. You guys, I may have spoken too soon. Like, I love how this looks when it sets. Like, this is giving me airbrush. Like, my face looks so flawless. All right, next we're gonna move on to the blush. So this is what it looks like outside of its packaging. It kind of looks like a lipstick. So I can see why people get a little bit confused, but yeah, it's a blush. And I'm actually gonna shake this up as well. I heard this is really, really pigmented. So something's like tempting me to do it the way how Selena does it. She puts like two dots on each side of her face and then blend it out. So I think I want to try that. But you guys, look at the doe foot applicator. This is really, really like juicy. Like, I don't know how to describe it, but I really like the applicator. I like the applicator on all of the products. So here we go. I'm doing a little bit of this. I'm not trying to go overboard, but yeah. Oh, and I don't know if I mentioned to you guys the shade of this, but it's in the shade Love. And then we're gonna blend this out. Oh yeah, it's super pigmented. Oh my gosh. I like to contour with blush. It makes your makeup look so much better, you guys. Like, I don't know if I like applying it with a beauty blender. I think a brush may be better. Or maybe I waited too long because it does dry down matte. Let's see on this side. Yeah, you have to work really fast with this, you guys, because it definitely dried down within a couple seconds. But nonetheless, the color is really nice. I'm just gonna add, a little more and blend. I think I like it better with a brush. Yeah, I like it better with a brush than the beauty blender. I'm just gonna add a little bit of more setting powder. I love how the sponge have like different dimensions to it, so it creates like that perfect sharp line for, you know, the places that I need like a sharp line. I don't know if I mentioned it to you guys, but I went back to an oldie but a goodie setting powder. This is the Airspun powder. And I don't know, lately I just fell back in love with it. Like, I just forgot how good it was, but yeah, that's what I've been using lately. Okay, before my camera dies, we're gonna move right along. Next, what do we have? All right guys, so this is what the liner looks like. The liner, you guys, glides on really, really smoothly. I don't know if you call it hairs or what, but the tip of this liner, you guys, you can adjust it to forming whatever shape you like. This tip is like perfect for like a really nice wing. All right, lashes are on and this is how we are looking. I'm actually really liking this, you guys. Oh, everything is just coming together really nicely. Now let's move on to our lips. So I have a lip balm and a lip cream. So the lip cream is a little bit darker than the lip balm. So I'm gonna use that on the outer part of my lips. I got it in like a brown shade. This is what it looks like outside of its packaging. This is really, really pretty, you guys. I always love like a brown lip, like, oh, it just does something to me. So the wand looks like this. It's like clear up here. And then this is how the doe foot looks. That looks really, really nice. Looks like it picks up a lot of products. We're gonna go ahead and apply this. Oh, it is really, really soft, you guys. Oh, she did not lie when she said that it's soft. Super soft. I wish she had a lip liner because I feel like that's what's missing here. But you guys, this feels really, really nice on the lips. It's super soft. It does feel like a velvet. Like I'm getting that velvet finish that she was talking about. Should I leave it like this? I'm not gonna lie, I thought it was a little bit darker. I was hoping for more of like a dark brown versus more of like a red undertone brown, but that's fine. I kind of still want to try the lip balm though. So this is what it looks like. It is white. It has an interesting shape. And this is what it looks like. I'm just gonna apply. Oh, that feels really, really soft as well. It's definitely hydrating. I feel the hydration. Yeah. See, it adds a little sheen to my lips. It's very comfortable. Yeah, it's cute. I'm gonna go ahead and line this really quick. I'm gonna use my favorite lip liner at the moment. It is from Morphe. It's in the shade Trendsetter. This is cute. Yeah. Yeah, this is really, really cute, you guys. Adding the liner just like added, it's like finishes touches to it, and that's what it's needed. So hopefully she comes out with some liners to, you know, finish off that lip. Pulling this right out of the packaging, I can see some oil bubbles in the solution, so I'm guessing this is gonna give me more of a glow instead of more of a matte finish. I'm gonna shake it up and we're gonna see. Oh, that sprays really nicely. Ooh, it has like a minty smell, and the spritz is really nice, really nice. All right, guys, so this is the final look. This is how everything came out. I'm actually pleasantly surprised, you guys. I didn't know what to expect from this. In the beginning, you know, we started off a little bit shaky. The foundation was a little bit too dark, and the concealer was not giving me that highlighted look that I was looking for, but to my surprise, everything did come together really, really nicely. I love the way the foundation finishes on my face. I don't feel like, it doesn't feel cakey, it doesn't feel oily, grease, like it's literally like perfect sitting on my face. The foundation is definitely buildable, you guys. I could have went in for another layer, but trust me, a little bit goes a long way. I did not need all the little dots I placed on my face. So yeah, a little bit definitely goes a long way. The lip, you guys, oh, it's so comfortable. And she's not lying. Like, it is definitely like a velvety feeling to it, right? It's super, super comfortable. I just wish she came out with a liner to, you know, finish off that lip combo. But yeah, this is really, really nice, you guys. The setting spray was actually good as well. It adds like the perfect amount of glow. I was actually very scared that it was gonna make me look too greasy, but it didn't. So yeah, for the blush, you guys, ooh, you guys saw it dry down really, really fast. So you want to make sure you work really fast with that blush. But when you blend it out, it just looks really, really nice on the skin. I love the way it dried down matte. I think I would definitely prefer the matte finish versus the more of a dewy, glowy finish. The color is really, really nice too. It's not too pink and it's not too like red either. It's like perfect, like that perfect blush. This is the type of blush color that I like. For the concealer, like I told you guys, I do love the consistency of the concealer. I just wish that the shade was a little bit brighter, but I'm not gonna lie, it looks really, really good. So I think I can work with these products. My face really looks airbrushed. The liner, how can we forget the liner, you guys? The liner is actually really, really good for making that perfect wing liner. So I definitely recommend that liner if you're looking for a nice matte black liner. But yeah, guys, overall, I really, really, really do like these products. Shout outs to her, because I've never put on foundation or makeup in general, you guys, and my face have never felt this light. Like, I don't even feel like I have anything on my face. So that's one thing I have to say about these products. Like, they're so lightweight, it doesn't feel like anything on your face. So yeah, that definitely gave, you know, her a little bit of points, because I hate feeling like I have a whole bunch of makeup and products on my face. Each product lived up to its description, so yeah, I definitely recommend it. They're really good and I think you guys will like them. So yeah, don't hesitate to check it out. This concludes my review. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to like. If you aren't subscribed to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, girl. And if you're not following me on Instagram, make sure you do so as well. The link is going to be down in the description bar. So with that being said, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.